It was a poster on the wall, launch and land your experiment. It was sponsored by NASA and the National Science Teachers Association. Come up with an experiment that could be conducted aboard the space shuttle. We raised chickens, you know, at our house, and I enjoyed seeing the process, and it was very interesting to see how the hen would roll over on the egg to counter the effects of gravity. And so now you take that chicken egg and you put it in space where there is no gravity, and how's that baby chick going to develop? I thought that would be a great experiment to see, okay, what kind of impact does microgravity environment have on that chicken egg that actually became the national winner. NASA came to Kentucky Fried Chicken and they said, this is a great project. We would love to get behind this. We are, you know, so supportive of the science and the engineering and the educational aspects of this project that it would be a good project for us to sponsor. Kentucky Fried Chicken actually wanted to have the project up on the Space Shuttle Challenger with the teacher. So I had the opportunity to be able to train Crystal McAuliffe. I was so caught up in the excitement and the opportunity. I mean, to be able to be with Crystal McAuliffe and Barbara Morgan and be with the astronauts. And so I was actually there the day that the Challenger launched. And so it was a very tragic day, horrible day. I actually had the opportunity to refly my experiment 3 years later. Kentucky Fried Chicken actually went back and refunded the project, and we got to fly again on Space Shuttle Discovery with John Blaha, and he's actually a Purdue grad, and he was actually the one that helped do the experiment. We're in Florida for the launch, and so it was quite a day. I remember, you know, tears coming down your eye, because here this whole project had started as an eighth grader, and just the journey that I had taken, you know, the multiple times that I'd actually work on this project, just the fact that it had gone through the Challenger experience and actually was fortunate enough to have the opportunity to refly it. So if you combined all those experiences, it was quite a process before it actually took off going into space. We had the ground unit that was identical to the unit that was on the space shuttle. We were providing the same thermal and humidity conditions to the ground control unit that the flight unit was experiencing up in space. And then when the shuttle landed, we took the eggs out of both units of the ground control and actually the flight unit that had been in space. And then we compared the embryos of those two groups. And then there was a set that we actually let hatch out. We actually took back, you know, to Purdue and actually let them hatch out.
My experiment really went better than ever anticipated. And that to me is one of the greatest feelings in the world, because you put all this time and all this effort into something you work on for 9 years. And there's times when you really wonder, is it all worth it? And the results have been so fantastic and so exciting.
The people that we worked with said, wow, you were able to do this very efficiently, very cost effectively. You know, your innovation, your technology was very successful. We need more technologies. We need more innovation like this. I graduated from Purdue. I moved down to Louisville, Kentucky, and we just started the company up, and that's all we've been doing ever since. Techshot is very active in trying to be part of biomanufacturing in a microgravity environment. NASA came to us and said, okay, we need instruments and tools to be able to do more robust experimentation on the International Space Station. And so a bone densitometer is a great device to be able to study bone loss. Bone loss is a big thing in space. You can study different aging drugs, you can study osteoporosis, and so they said we need a tool to be able to do more of this type of research. And so Techshot was asked to actually put together a bone densitometer to be able to have the ability to be able to measure bone mineral density. A lot of the research that's being conducted aboard the International Space Station actually has direct benefits to people here on Earth. And so a lot of the aging population, for example, with the bone densitometer can benefit if we can come up with more effective treatments for osteoporosis. I enjoy the innovation. The innovation is what gets me. I love the challenge. I was told the bone densitometer will not make it. It will not go up on orbit. And that's the challenge that I enjoy, is because I feel like we have the innovation, the technology to be able to do these things in a unique way, you know, to have a positive impact. And that's what I want to do. I want to have a positive impact. I want to have a positive impact here back on Earth. It's a dream job, because I get to work on innovation. I get to work with creative people to come up with instrumentation devices that could potentially have huge impact to society here on Earth.